you for joining us again. I am Erica McBride, the Director of Community Development here at Aspyre Rock Creek Memory Care. Today I have an exciting guest. I have Emily LeBlanc with Senior Helpers. Hi, Emily.
Hello, Erica. Thanks for having me today. I'm Emily with Senior Helpers, and I'm really excited to be joining you.
Awesome. We are excited as well. To get started, can you tell everybody a little bit about Senior Helpers as a company, what you guys do, things like that?
Yeah, so Senior Helpers is a fairly small in-home non-medical senior care company. So we started about 3 years ago and have been growing ever since, but we are located out in LaPorte. Our main office is in LaPorte, and then we expand from the LaPorte, Wellington area all the way down to Greeley. So we can go to people's homes, we can go to facilities, we can help pretty much wherever help is needed, and we can do all of the non-medical services that you or a loved one would need.
Nice. And whenever you say non-medical, what services can in-home non-medical caregivers give?
Yeah, so in-home non-medical caregivers can do anything from companionship care all the way up to personal care. So for the companionship stuff, it would be things like just sitting and talking or doing activities such as walking around or arts and crafts or painting or any fun stuff like that that keeps the brain active and also keeps the body active. We can also do housekeeping and pet care and laundry and dishes as well if that's ever needed. And that definitely helps with people who don't have great balance or maybe have arthritis or things like that. But we can also do the more advanced care, so the personal care side. That would be things like toileting, bathing. Our caregivers are also trained in Parkinson's care and also Alzheimer's and dementia care. So if anyone's needing a little bit more care with memory or getting around, we can do that as well.
Nice. So you kind of get the whole range of cares there, and that's amazing. What is the difference between home health care and non-medical senior care?
Yeah, so the difference between home health care and non-medical senior care is that home health care comes in and does the medical stuff with you. So that would be things like placing IVs or directly giving medications or teaching physical therapy moves that would be more advanced or skilled care. But for the non-medical stuff, we can help with those types of things, but we can't actually administer. So we can do hand-over-hand methods of taking pills and things like that, but we can't actually be the person who administers pills. Same with the skilled work of PT. We would be able to practice moves or help stabilize someone who is working through physical therapy, but we can't be the people who actually show them the moves to do.
Gotcha, nice. And as we all know, we're living in crazy times, especially for our senior living world. What precautions can your caregivers take going into the homes during all of the COVID-19 stuff going on?
Yeah, so with any home care or senior care place that you look into, if you're looking for that right now, you should definitely look into what they're doing for COVID. Here, we're very closely monitoring symptoms of both our clients and our caregivers to give both parties safe, or to keep both parties safe. And so we monitor the symptoms closely. Whenever anyone has any symptoms, we immediately pull them from their shifts and we make sure to monitor their temperature twice a day for at least 3 days, depending on if their symptoms go away or stay. And then if they stay, then we have to get them COVID tested as well. And we can't have them returning to work until they are tested. In the house, we have all of our caregivers wearing masks and gloves when necessary and taking all the proper precautions, such as hand washing frequently and cleaning heavily touched surfaces. But it's been a crazy time, but make sure if you are looking for senior care or if you're looking for, home care or a facility or a memory care unit, make sure you're looking somewhere that does keep up with the safety requirements.
Definitely. And the senior care that you guys provide, is that only for seniors 65 and older? Is there like an age restriction? What does that look like?
Yeah, so we can actually accept anyone who needs help. We are a private company and we don't just take in seniors who are 65 plus. We take anyone who needs it. So that is people who maybe have onset Parkinson's or early onset dementia and are needing a little extra care. But it can also be for those people who maybe had a knee surgery and are just in their 40s or 50s and are needing help getting around the house and don't have anyone else there to help them. Or even if you're getting a surgery and needing someone to drive you to the doctors and drive you home, we can do that as well. So it's not just the people who are 65 plus.
Nice. Awesome. And how can the caregivers that you guys send into these homes, how can they help prevent falls for the residents that they care for?
Yeah, so having a caregiver in the home can prevent falls, which also helps prevent hospitalization and also those crazy fees that we know we can get at the hospital. We can definitely rack up a lot with falls. So having a caregiver in the home can help in a variety of ways. I mean, the most obvious would be assisting someone when they get out of bed to the bathroom or to the kitchen or wherever they need to go, or being able to transfer them from bed to chair or chair to standing or bed to toilet, whatever it may be. But the caregivers can also see other things in the home, like they can see warning signs of falls, such as, you know, a leak in the bathroom that could cause a fall, or rugs that are gathered on the floor that could cause a fall if someone doesn't see them. They can also prevent falls in other ways, like helping older adults regain balance by helping them exercise. They can also prevent falls by helping with the activities of daily living, such as doing the chores and things like that, so that the older adult doesn't have to do it themselves.
Nice. And I know a lot of, the homes that you guys are going into right now, these people probably aren't wanting to leave their house so much right now. They're probably trying to stay isolated whenever they can. How do your caregivers go in and help them prevent that isolated feeling in these aging adults, especially during COVID right now?
Yeah. So our caregivers are able to do a little bit of that prevention of isolation by, you know, just first of all, being there, being able to be a companion to an older adult who may not see anyone else in their average routine, you know, being able to talk with them and sit down. And if the older adult wants to watch TV, it's someone who you can talk to about what's going on on TV or on the game shows that they're watching or the football or whatever it is. We can also go in, like I said before, and do crafts or go for walks or things like that, which keep the mind and body active. And that is a big part of social isolation as well, is the activity section of it. But another way that we can help with isolation in older adults is by connecting them to their families. A lot of older adults feel isolated because they don't know how to work technology well. And with our caregivers, a lot of them are younger, and they're able to pull up Zoom or pull up Facebook and show them, like, this is how you can connect with your family, and I can definitely be here to help you. I can help you make that phone call. I can help you do the FaceTime, whatever it is that you need to do to connect with your family. Our caregivers can be there and make that connection.
That's awesome. That is all very important, especially during these times. I just want to say thank you so much for joining me today. It's been a pleasure having you, and I'm happy we got to learn so much more about what Senior Helpers has to offer.
Yeah, thank you so much, Erica. It was so nice being on today, and I hope that I provided some good answers and a valuable resource if anyone needs some in-home care.
Yes, definitely. I did have one more question. If somebody needed your guys' services, how would they get in contact with you?
Yeah, so the The best way to contact us for services would be to call our office number, and that is 970-658-8228. And if you call that number, we have someone answering the phones 24/7. So one of us here in the office is always on that on-call phone, and we'll be able to answer your questions and figure out what your needs are and help you right away.
Awesome. Well, thank you again so much. And I hope you have a great rest of your week.
Yeah, you too. Thank you.
Thank you.